YouTube, I have to make a video right now because I had a revelation a couple minutes ago. I was using the restroom and I felt my bladder crying out to me, like saying, you know, like I call my legs, I often call them my mean girls. I say my left leg is the bossy and controlling one, and the right leg just kind of goes along with her. And so, anyway, or just does whatever she can do to make my life difficult. But, and I say my bladder is like a sadistic master who controls my every move. Okay, so when I was using the restroom just now, I realized that I have been characterizing my body wrong. My legs are not my mean girls. My legs are hurting. My legs are, yeah, they do have minds of their own, but they are struggling too. This MS that I have, it's not just affecting me, it's affecting my body, my body parts, my bladder. My bladder isn't this controlling sadistic master. It is just like it's as affected by MS as the rest of me. And it is scared. Like, it doesn't like when I go sit on the restroom, then, you know, I'm usually in a hurry. Because by the time I finally get to the restroom, then, you know, I'm like, lucky if I transfer over, you know, because I get urgency and stuff. And so, anyway, like, so my bladder, I don't think that it's demanding and bossy and controlling and trying to tell me, like, you better get there or I'm gonna pee. I think that my bladder is just like, help, you know, like when I sense that urge just in the beginning, that's my bladder saying, help, help, I feel something, you know, it's your warning. Okay, so then I have to learn how to listen to that warning. And I think I've been doing better, just that slight tinge or whatever, which a lot of people don't get, and I get that. But anyway, my point is, okay, so my bladder is trying to work too, but it can't, you know, because I have this thing called MS, which affects my body and my body parts. But ultimately, we're all in this together. And I think it's really important that I love my body and that I nurture it. When my legs are crying out or being difficult, being bratty, what do you do with difficult kids? You know, you don't call them mean, you don't turn your back on them, you don't like force them into position or whatever. You love on them, you nurture them and care for them. And I think that I've really been treating my body wrong in so many ways, and I think my bladder too. So, like, you know, the diapers and like all that stuff, that is, it's not because I have this mean thing that's pushing me around or whatever, it's because I have something that's injured, and so it can't work properly. And so anyway, like, that's my revelation. And so you, like, when you're out there and hurting or whatever, like, I don't know, maybe you can remember your body is hurting too, you know? Like, I don't know. It's just, it's all new for me because it changes my whole mindset, because for so long I have really thought of my body as working against me, and so now maybe it's just dirt too, you know, like, that totally makes sense. I don't know why I didn't get it till now, but anyway, that's life. Bye.